Well, it's that time of year when you do some spring cleaning, right? And while you're tidying up the closet and the garage and stuff around the house, don't forget to clean out your computer. Our gaming and gadgets expert, Marc Saltzman, joins us live via Skype from Toronto with five tips for whipping our computers back into shape. Marc, my computer is so dreadfully slow. I can't imagine what's in there that I can get rid of. What's your first tip?
Yeah, and you're not alone, Rob. So instead of having to run out and buy a whole new computer, a few of these simple, plain English tips should help you out. So number one, back up your important information before you do anything. So it doesn't matter how you do it. You can use a USB thumb drive. You can use an external hard drive. You can burn a disk or even use a free online service like Windows Live SkyDrive or iCloud. The point is, take those documents, those photos, those irreplaceable camcorder footage that you've got, and upload it or burn it, back it up, just in case you accidentally delete it when you're trying to spring clean your computer. So that's tip number one, back it up.
I've done that onto a hard drive, and the problem is I can't find the hard drive, so I have to be more organized that way. So you get those files off, but there's got to be, what's this maintenance that people talk of, like programs that you just don't use anymore? How do you know which ones you use and which ones you don't?
Right. So the second tip would be to clear the clutter. Take a look in your program files if you're using Windows, or on your desktop if you're a Mac user, and just look at them. If you haven't played a game that was bundled with your computer 4 years ago, then it's time to delete it. So you're getting more hard drive space back, but you're going to be just cleaning it out, getting rid of all those icons, all that wallpaper that you can't see anymore because it's littered with icons. Just clean it out. Get rid of the programs you don't use. If you're not sure, when in doubt, don't uninstall it, of course. Mm-hmm. And don't just delete the icon either. You need to go, for example, in Windows, to Program Files, which is built in there, and you'll be able to see which ones to properly uninstall.
Your third tip I've actually done. It's called defragging, but I have no idea what that means. What exactly is defragging?
Right. You think you need a geek to English dictionary
exactly.
Just to figure out what to do. Well, there are built-in system tools, both Windows and Macs, that will essentially clean up your hard drive for you. So if you don't want to go to the extreme and erase or format your entire hard drive and install a fresh operating system, defrag is one of those options under system tools that will essentially comb through your hard drive, which again is the drive that stores all of the contents of your computer, and it'll rearrange all those little zeros and ones in a way so that it'll be optimized for performance. So it'll be faster, you'll retrieve more hard disk space, and you just want to let it go. So maybe if you're doing this on a home computer, before you go to sleep at night, click that defrag and then walk away, and then in the morning it'll be done and good as new.
Your next tip, Marc, is to update your software that you use regularly. I often say later or check, not now, because I'm of the faith, if it's not broke, don't fix it. And I've seemingly updated software and then something gets broken in the process. Is that, just user error, or should you update all programs?
Generally speaking, when there are updates available for your software, such as Skype, which is what we're talking on right now, the software engineers have found mistakes and security vulnerabilities and added new features that you should take advantage of. So generally speaking, when you ship software, whether it's the entire operating system or a program like Skype or iTunes, they find ways to improve it. So definitely take advantage of that. If there's an option to have it install automatically, check that off. Otherwise, you need to manually update it. So just go to the About section of all your favorite pieces of software and just make sure you update it once in a while.
Okay, your last one. We don't have much time left, but you have to update your antivirus software. I've recently joined the Mac world, but now I'm reading that even Macs need antivirus software.
That's right. If you don't want to spend $40 a year for software on your Mac or PC, there are free options. Antivirus is a must in today's day and age. Go to download.com, take a look at the top 10 list, and you'll find lots of free and good options.
All right, good stuff. Marc Saltzman via Skype from Toronto. Nice to have you join us north of the border, and good advice. We'll see you next time.
Thanks, Rob.